Hello, welcome. Finally, version 2.1 of Cemu has been released. I, who always said that Cemu didn't bring significant updates, was surprised this time. Version 2.1 is packed with new features. However, I know many of you are still using version 1.26.2, which many consider the best version for Zelda Breath of the Wild. So, in today's video, we'll talk about the new features in version 2.1 and make comparisons between versions 1.26.2, 2.0, and 2.1. Is it now worth moving from version 1.26.2 straight to 2.1, even for those with a more modest PC? Let's start by discussing the changelog. If you want to skip directly to the tests, just check the progress bar on your YouTube video. Starting the changelog with some important new additions, added app image and flat pack versions for Linux. Added an experimental version for macOS, currently available only for x86-64, but it can run on ARM Macs through Rosetta 2 emulation. The graphics API that will run on Mac is Molten VK. Support has been added for the portals required to make peripherals used in Skylanders and Disney Infinity games work. Added NFC ATG support, allowing Pokemon Rumble U figures to now be scanned. Added support for WAB files, which are homebrew files for Wii U. Added support for online games through the Pretendo network, though it's still necessary to dump files from an original Wii U. If you install Cemu for the first time now, it will no longer be in portable mode. For updates, the old method will continue to work. And for those who would like to do a fresh installation and keep it in portable mode, just create a folder named Portable in the directory where Cemu is stored. Now, let's move on to the general additions. I'll only mention the most important ones because there's really a lot. Experimental support for gamepads with built-in microphones was added, allowing for features like blowing into the controller. Various issues related to the gamepad screen size have been fixed. A regression issue that prevented Tokyo Mirage Sessions and Pokane Tournament from starting has been fixed. The regression that caused failures in the Mi system, which could cause issues in Sonic Lost World and Super Mario 3D World, has also been fixed. Ryugei Gotoku 1 and 2 HD and Steam World Collection are now playable. It's now possible to close a game without having to close Cemu entirely. Full screen mode can now be activated by pressing the F11 key. The latency of the H264 decoder has been reduced when decoding frames asynchronously. In the user interface, Cemu received the following updates. In the general settings, there's now an option called Receive Untested Updates. I recommend keeping this option enabled to always have the most up-to-date and complete versions of the project. Open Cemu folder and open MLC folder options have been added. Just like in Yuzu, clicking these options will take you directly to the desired folder without having to search manually in the system. Various issues related to game names in the user interface and the title manager have been fixed. Now, hardware-related fixes. CPU. Improved PowerPC emulation, which increases compatibility with some Unity games and DS Virtual Console titles. GPU. Added support for more shader instructions, like Cafe GSL, which can be used in some games and homebrews. Optimized shader decompiler output, slightly reducing shader compilation times. I tested this feature, and you'll see the difference in the following tests. Remove the shader molecularity min option, which didn't provide any benefits. Fix Cheetah bug in Breath of the Wild where the weapon trail effect sometimes rendered in solid red. Fix several issues where the shader decompiler could generate broken GSL. Correcting rainbow colors on characters in Tekken Tag Tournament 2. This feature was also tested and will be shown in the following tests. Various minor updates were implemented in the GPU. OpenGL API. Cemu shall no longer crash if OpenGL fails to initialize. Fix Cheetah regression where Cemu's precompiled shader cache for OpenGL was not actually being used. Reduce texture read latency. Fixing severe FPS drops in Breath of the Wild whenever something is set on fire. Important note, it is recommended to always use the Vulkan API, leaving OpenGL only for older GPUs that do not support Vulkan. Vulkan API. Asynchronous shader compilation is now enabled by default. Multi-threaded Pipeline compilation during the shader cache loading screen is re-enabled on Nvidia drivers, resulting in much faster pipeline loading. Fixed the invisible rupee counter in Twilight Princess HD. Improved floating point emulation accuracy in shaders, fixing misposition members and mobs in Minecraft. Fixed Cheetah crash in Sonic Transformed. Controller improvements. Added a pairing tool for Wiimotes, now with support for Linux and macOS as well. Added support for analog triggers for DSU API controllers. Increased the frequency of pad KPD sampling callbacks. Fixing high controller latency in Pokemon Rumble U. Audio. For new installations, the default audio driver has been switched to Cubeb. Other improvements. Various improvements related to graphic packs and patches, debug, CafeOS, and HLE have been added, though they are not relevant to basic or intermediate users like us. If you want to access the full log for version 2.1, I'll leave the link in the video description. Now, before we start with the tests, please leave a like to help promote this video and share it in other emulation communities. If this is your first time on the channel, consider subscribing and hitting the bell to stay updated on the latest news firsthand. All the tests conducted here were recorded under the same conditions, same graphic quality, same resolution, etc. There is no video editing to speed up or slow down the tests, ensuring fairness for all the projects tested. Note on version 1.26.2, many people still insist on staying with version 1.26.2, believing it to be the smoothest for Zelda, Breath of the Wild. Indeed, this version has some advantages over others, but its shader compilation is slower in most games and may present random issues, as we'll see below. First game tested, Bayonetta 2. Since the emulator was updated to version 2.0 or later, excessive blur bugs have appeared during cutscenes, as you can see. This problem persists regardless of the video settings or graphic packs used. In version 1.26.2, the game runs perfectly with the same settings, without any bugs. Some people suggest that the issue is caused by VSync or the 60fps cutscene mod. However, as you can see, version 2.1 was using the 60fps cutscene mod, while 2.0 was not, and the problem remained. Despite this, version 1.26.2 suffers from shader generation issues, causing severe stutters. For those who want to play Bayonetta 2, I recommend using Sudachi or Ryujinx, with the Wii U version being more appropriate only if your PC cannot handle Nintendo Switch emulators. Cemu is much more optimized than the Switch emulators, requiring less hardware. Mario Kart 8 showed behavior similar to Bayonetta 2, but without the graphical bugs. The game is rendered perfectly, without visual issues. However, when looking at the low 1% statistic, we see that version 1.26.2 struggles with shader compilation, dropping to a mere 11fps compared to the constant 52fps in versions 2.0 and 2.1. These performance drops affect gameplay, causing noticeable pauses. Another observation was the lower CPU usage in version 2.1. Although Mario Kart 8 has a more complete and fun Switch port, if you have a modest PC, Cemu is a good option. I recommend version 2.1 for its lower GPU usage and fast shader compilation. Super Smash Bros. With 8 characters on screen. The slow shader compilation in version 1.26 is evident, with FPS drops reaching 40 at times. This may not completely ruin the gaming experience, but it is always better to use a smoother version without these slowdowns. Additionally, I noticed higher CPU usage in version 2.0, along with about 200 MB more RAM usage. In the low 1% comparison, version 1.26 performs the worst, indicating it is less optimized. In Tekken Tag Tournament 2, version 1.26 presented several problems. Characters rendered without textures or with completely broken colors. Since the game has not yet been released for PC, it can only be played via emulation. On Xenia, the game is broken, and RPCS3 sometimes faces issues recognizing DLCs. Additionally, version 1.26 has minor lighting issues and suffers from shader compilation, often causing the scene or even the characters to appear incomplete while the game is running. In version 2.1, CPU consumption was slightly reduced, and these issues are minimized. Therefore, the recommendation is to use version 2.1 to play Tekken Tag Tournament 2. Although the game is still exclusive to consoles, it can be enjoyed through emulation with a more stable experience on the latest Cemu version. Xenoblade Chronicles X is a great game for running a decent benchmark on Cemu, especially since there's a mod that unlocks the FPS. As can be seen, version 1.26 can reach 60fps. But with a lot of effort, mostly staying around 50fps. On the other hand, version 2.0 achieves an average of 80fps, almost double that of 1.26, though with higher resource consumption. This is acceptable because if the demand for resources is higher and the game delivers better performance, it's worth it. However, version 2.1 manages to do even better, consuming only slightly more resources than 1.26 and delivering better performance than version 2.0, with an average FPS of 85 compared to 82 on version 2.0. Next, I'll leave the results of our tests for you to analyze. Effort is its own reward. Sir. And finally, we have the test everyone was waiting for, which is the best Cemu version to play Zelda Breath of the Wild. Now yes, version 1.26 has an advantage over the others, but with some caveats. During gameplay, at certain moments, the FPS gain can be more than 10 compared to the other versions. However, there were peaks of CPU usage reaching 70%, while the other two contenders hardly exceeded 40%. This time, stutters were not a problem, keeping our low 1% measure practically tied across all projects. The new version 2.1 consumes slightly more RAM, but only about 250 megabytes, which is practically insignificant in a game that uses around 10 gigabytes. I'll leave the results of this comparison in the video, so you can see our benchmark at the end of this test. Conclusion, we can see that version 2.1 is slightly better than version 2.0. It presents lower resource usage, such as CPU, and in most games, had slightly lower RAM consumption. Additionally, it manages to run most games with a much better level of detail and accuracy than version 1.26. So if you are someone who plays many games, version 2.1 is the best option for you. But it's always good to have version 1.26 on hand if you want to play Bayonetta 2, for example. Its shader compilation is fast and efficient enough not to interfere in most games, and the shaders created in version 2.0 are still compatible with version 2.1, avoiding the need to compile thousands of shaders present in Zelda Breath of the Wild. Version 2.0, at this point, becomes obsolete, with no more reasons to be used. As for version 1.26, it will still provide better results in games like Zelda, Breath of the Wild or Bayonetta 2, but if you are not playing those two games, I see no need to use it. Unlike version 2, the shaders from version 1.26 are incompatible with version 2, so if you upgrade, you will have to compile all the shaders again. Also, there's no point in trying to download shaders from other people, as was done in the past, since in the Vulkan API, shaders are directly linked to the hardware that compiles them. And that was the video. I hope it was useful for you. Thanks for watching and see you next time.